Hello. In today's video, we shall learn in detail about genus Ustilago. By the end of this video, you will have a clear understanding about different types of smut diseases, structure of Ustilago, various methods of dikaryotization, reproduction, and about its alternation of generations. Let us start with the introduction to order Ustilaginales. The order Ustilaginales includes the smut fungi. They are highly specialized parasites of higher plants. The smut fungi do not form fructification. They cause destructive diseases known as the smut diseases, which results in economical loss to cereal crops. The mycelium in the host is intercellular. The binucleate cells of the hyphae form thick-walled resting spores known as smut spores or teleutospores. Ustilago is the largest genus of the family Ustilaginaceae. All species are parasitic and infect the floral parts of the members of the grass family, particularly the cereals such as corn, oat, barley, wheat, etc. All species of the genus complete their life cycle on one host and are known as autoecious parasites. They produce black, sooty, powdery mass of spores on the host plant and are commonly known as the smut fungi. There are two kinds of smut diseases, loose smuts and covered smuts. In the loose smuts, at the flowering time, the black sooty mass of spores is exposed and is easily blown away by wind, leaving the stalk of inflorescence bare or naked. Example, loose smut of barley is caused by Ustilago nuda. In the covered smuts, the black powder of spores remain covered by the wall of the grain and the spores are liberated only by breaking the wall during threshing. Example, covered smut of barley caused by Ustilago hodei. Next, let us look into the vegetative structure of Ustilago. The mycelium of Ustilago are of two types, primary mycelium and secondary mycelium. The primary mycelium is monokaryotic, with single haploid nucleus in each cell. The mycelium is septate, haline, and slender. It is formed by the germination of basidiospore and is of very short duration. The secondary mycelium is formed by dikaryotization of primary mycelium. The hyphae consists of two haploid nuclei in each cell. These hyphae are septate and highly branched. The hyphae may be intercellular or intracellular, and haustoria may or may not be present. When the mycelium is scattered throughout the various parts of the host, it is said to be systemic, and if it ramifies near the point of infection, it is said to be localized. By the way, if you're getting some value out of this video, please like and share the video so that all of us can learn, unlearn, and relearn together. Also, please consider subscribing the channel and press the bell icon to get instant notification of all the upcoming videos. Next, let us learn about dikaryotization in Ustilago. It is a process in which the primary mycelium produced by the germination of basidiospores changes into a secondary mycelium. There are various methods of dikaryotization in Eustilago. Dikaryotization may take place within the host by means of hyphal fusions, somatogamy, between hyphae of opposite strains. Example, Eustilago medus. Dikaryotization can also take place by fusion between the germ tubes of two germinating basidiospores. As the basidiospores germinate, the germ tubes of the basidiospores of opposite strain meet and fuse, as seen in Eustilago hordei, giving rise to the secondary mycelium. Next is dikaryotization by conjugation between the basidiospores. The basidiospores produce secondary spores, sporidia, by budding. Sporidia of opposite strains come close together, common wall dissolves, and the nucleus of one migrates into the other. The binucleate sporidium on germination produces the secondary mycelium. Example, Eustilago violacea. Dikaryotization can also take place by the union of infected threads. Haploid cells of promycelium grow into small, slender hyphae known as infection threads. Two neighboring infection threads of the opposite strains fuse. The nucleus of one passes into the other. The binucleate infection thread so formed grows into secondary mycelium as seen in Eustilago treatisei. Dikaryotization may occur by the fusion between the two haploid cells of opposite strains of the same basidium. Example, Eustilago hordei and Eustilago carbo. A dikaryotic cell can also be formed by the union of a basidiospore with one of the basidial cells of the opposite strain. Example, Eustilago violacea. Dikaryotization can also take place by fusion of two basidia. A dikaryotic cell is formed by the fusion between two basidia formed by the germination of smut spores of opposite strains. Eustilago nuda is an example. Dikaryotization can also occur by fusion of the basidiospore of one strain with the germ tube of the basidiospore of another strain. Next, we shall understand the process of reproduction in Eustilago. It takes place by sporulation and basidiospore formation. Sporulation: in wheat, at the flowering time of the host, the secondary mycelium becomes active, branches profusely, and infects the embryonic spikelets or inflorescence. The parenchymatous tissue in the embryonic spikelets is destroyed completely. Sporulation starts in the center of the hyphal mass. The hyphal wall thickens and gets gelatinized. The hyphae divide, forming short binucleate intertwined segments called sporogenous hyphae. The protoplast of each binucleate cell rounds off and wall becomes gelatinized. The protoplast secretes a thick wall around itself. It results in smut spore, or otherwise known as teliospore. When mature, the gelatinous matrix disappears. The spores appear as hard, compact mass called a smut ball or sorus. In Eustilago hordei, the sorus is covered by a peridium of host cells. The smuts in which the sori are covered by peridium are called covered smuts. In loose smuts, the sori are naked. Each sorus contains numerous thick-walled, rounded spores. The spore wall has an outer thick exine or exosporium and an inner thin intine or endosporium. The smut spores can be dispersed by wind, insects, or water. Only a small rachis persists on the infected ear after the dispersal of spores. Prior to germination, the two nuclei of opposite strain fuse to form a syncarion. During favorable condition, the spore absorbs moisture, swells up, and as a result, the exosporium ruptures, endosporium comes out as short promycelium or epibasidium. The diploid nucleus migrates into the promycelium and divides meiotically, resulting in four haploid nuclei, two of plus strain and two of minus strain. They are arranged in rows, and with the development of three transverse septa, the epibasidium or promycelium is composed of four haploid cells. Each cell sprouts a bud laterally towards its upper end. In each cell, the haploid nucleus divides mitotically into two daughter nuclei. One of these remain in the cell while the other migrates into the developing bud. These uninucleate buds form the basidiospores or sporidia. Two of these are of plus strain and two of minus strain. The basidiospore may produce a large number of secondary spores by budding. The basidiospores or sporidia germinate either on the soil or on the young host plant itself. Each basidiospore produces a germ tube or infection tube. The germ tube is haploid or monokaryotic. When the germ tube comes in contact with its opposite strain, both fuse together to form a dikaryotic cell, which then develops into a dikaryotic mycelium. This process is known as dikaryotization and is brought about differently in different species of Eustilago. Eustilago hordei causes covered smut of barley. The basidiospores germinate in the soil or on barley grains by producing germ tubes. Diploidization occurs when the haploid germ tubes of two opposite strains basidiospores fuse. One of the tube becomes dikaryotic and can infect the young seedling of barley. Eustilago tritici, the smut spore, germinates to produce promycelium or epibasidium on the stigma of the flower. Each basidium cell produces a haploid infection thread. The infection threads of the same basidium with nuclei of opposite strains fuse. This results in the formation of a binucleate or dikaryotic hypha. When it reaches the ovary, it branches and spreads into the intercellular spaces of the ovary and finally enters the ovule. It produces smut spores, which gets exposed when the host tissue decays. Spores are carried by wind, leaving behind the naked rachis. Eustilago maidis, corn smut. Infection takes place through any embryonic tissue of the host. Each smut spore germinates to produce 3 to 4 celled cylindrical epibasidium. Each cell of the epibasidium bears a basidiospore which is capable of budding and produces secondary basidiospores which are dispersed by wind. When the spores fall on a young corn plant, they form haploid germ tubes which easily infects any part of the plant. Diploidization takes place when the haploid germ tubes from 2 basidiospores of plus and minus strain fuse. The binucleate or dikaryotic cell forms secondary mycelium which branches extensively and forms the smut spores which appear as tumors on any portion of the host. Finally, we shall look into the alternation of generations. The gametophytic phase is represented by the haploid 4-celled epibasidium basidiospores, germ tubes of basidiospores, and the primary mycelium. Gametophytic phase ends with plasmogamy, which initiates the dikaryophase, which consists of the dikaryotic or secondary mycelium and the binucleate smut spores. With karyogamy ends the dikaryotic phase. The smut spore with the synkaryon represents the transitory diplophase. The dikaryotic phase and the transitory phase constitute the sporophytic phase, which ends with meiosis. With meiosis starts the future gametophyte. Hence, alternation of generation is exhibited in the life cycle of Eustilago. So today, we have learnt in detail about genus Eustilago, its modes of reproduction, different methods of dikaryotization and alternation of generation in its life cycle. I have some practice questions for you. Please share your answers in the comments section below. You can pause the video and write down the questions if you like. Thank you so much for your time and participation. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please consider subscribing the channel and press the bell icon to get instant notification of all the upcoming videos. Also, if you want to discuss any particular topic in biology, please mention that in the comment section below. I'll see you there. Goodbye. All the best.